Welcome to all of you. I'm a little bit late starting here. I was enchanted back there with some of our younger attendees. But thank you all for being here. This is our regular meeting of the Rockingham County Board of Commissioners. If you haven't already done so, please silence any electronic devices that make noise. And that would be appreciated. In a moment, I'm going to ask Ira Jessup, who's the minister for... Benaja, Mount Zion Holiness Church is going to deliver our invocation, and we're going to have our Pledge of Allegiance. Caroline Roseman is going to lead that. So I'm going to ask you at this time to please stand, and I'm going to ask Reverend Jessup to come forward. You can bend that thing. Thank you.
I'm kind of sure. Yes. Okay. Let us go before the Lord in prayer. First of all, I want to thank the Lord for allowing me to stand here tonight in a place that I've never stood before. And we want to thank Jesus for allowing us all to be here tonight. And Father God, in the name of Jesus, we come before you, calling your holy and precious name, Lord God. We ask you, Lord, to just come into the midst of this meeting, Lord God. And Father God, whatever the agendas are, oh Father God, we pray that you would be in the midst of it, Lord. That you would take full control, Lord God. And Father God, we lift up this county. We lift up Rockingham County as a whole. Not only Rockingham County, but all of the surrounding counties as well, Father God. Father God, whatever they need, Father God, whatever they have come here to ask for tonight, Father God, that if it's in your will, Father God, that it will be done, Father God. We thank you and we praise you, Father God, and we give you all the glory and honor and praise. Father God, we thank you, Lord God, for protecting each county, Lord God, from all the infirmities that's going around each and every state, Father God. We come against it right in the name of Jesus. We lose healing in this county and the surrounding counties. And Lord, we thank you and we praise you, Lord God, for every blessing, Father God, that you're going to give to each and every county and every agenda and everyone that's asking for something here tonight, Lord God, that you will provide for it. So, Father God, in the name of Jesus, we just thank you and praise you, Lord God, for touching each and every one that's here that's at this meeting, Father God. If there's anybody that's here that may be sick in their bodies, Lord God, we ask you, Lord, to touch their bodies right now, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you and we praise you, Lord God, for just allowing us to be here in this place tonight, Lord God, to express you, Lord God, to let them know, Father God, it's all about you, Lord God. It's not about them. It's all about you, because you are in control. And Lord, we thank you and we praise you and give you all the glory and honor and praise. In Jesus' precious name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Ms. Roseman.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Ms. Roseman, there. You are dismissed if you so choose there. And thank you, Reverend Jessup.
Now that she's got other care of us.
Oh, so we had a larceny.
Gentlemen, you've had the agenda now for greater than 10 days, chance to review it. Are there any amendments, changes, or do we have a motion to approve as presented?
Motion approved.
Second. Motion. Moved and second. Further discussion? Hearing none. All in favor indicate by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed by nay. Right. Recognition there. Donation. Oh, the fire marshal there is getting some money. So I'm not exactly sure who I should call up on this, but I suppose.
Lance, I guess. Fire marshal. Call the fire marshal.
Well, yeah. Well, I think we have a contingent of folks and somebody representing Bridgestone. Andrea Davis, if you would, can you come around up here, and we're going to come down and kind of surround you as you make this presentation so that we can thank you properly.
All of that and thank Bridgestone.
What I'd like to start off with saying is, and by the way, I'm Melissa Joyce, I'm one of the assistant fire marshals here at the county, and I really want to, I'm not a really good public speaker, but what I want to say is that we want to send out our sincerest gratitude and thanks to Bridgestone. We do fire extinguisher classes for them, as well as many other businesses and schools and other sorts of things within the county. And Bridgestone has been so generous to us. Our pan is over 15 years old and no longer operational. We tried to get it repaired, and it worked a couple of times, and then it went back to the same problem again. So I had the joy of getting to know the Bridgestone staff last year when we were doing classes there for fire extinguishers as well as hose advancement classes. And so then this year, to our surprise, Julie reached out to me the first of the year when we scheduled our classes for the 2020 year and said that Bridgestone wanted to make a donation. Now, what you all don't understand is our training props for the fire extinguishers, they cost $12,000. So when you're looking at a budget year for that and trying to come back and ask you guys for $12,000, it's, you know, because we don't charge for these classes. These are classes to teach people how to do things. So to be more safe at home in their business. And so when Bridgestone come back and told me that, what they initially said was that, hey, we want to make a donation for your burn pan, because that's what we call it. We want to make a donation. So we reached out, we started wheels turning. Of course, this all takes place when I'm out of the office, so I had to pull Jeremy into it and harass Rodney a little bit and get Will pulled into it to find out what the proper steps were, because you can't just go out here and accept donations from people. There's certain channels you have to go through. And so we jumped through all the hoops, and it's been a couple of weeks now, and we went and met at Bridgestone the last week of January, and they presented me a check, just kind of like what we would do right here, right now, presenting a check to us. And then once we got done, Julie was like, did you see how much it was? And I was like, no, because I'm the type of person is that I'm thankful for anything I get. So, you know, I'm not, beggars aren't choosy. So I was just, when I opened the envelope and seen it was a $12,000 check, I think you could pick my mouth up off the floor. So what Bridgestone has enabled us to do is we're able to purchase an entire new training system, the new burn pan, the new extinguishers and everything. And I know y'all don't realize how many people we reach, thousands of people in this county every year with our training classes, our pub ed, going out and doing inspections in businesses. We really do reach a whole lot of people. And me personally, from myself, the other fire marshals, head fire marshal, emergency services, and I'm sure the commissioners and all the people in the county, we sincerely do appreciate it. We cannot say thank you enough. So,
we're going to give you a chance to speak here in a second. I'm sure that'll be great. But we like to give people these Rockingham County pins that remind you that you're in a good place. But I want you to take particularly good care of that, because it strikes me that that one cost $12,000.
I'll make sure we wear it proud.
Well, on behalf of Bridgestone, you know, we can't thank you enough for all you guys do for us. Between the trainings with the fire extinguishers and the hose training, you know, you're helping keep all of our teammates and our plant safe. And not only that, it's the least we could do to give back, you know, because we know it's not just us you take care of. You take care of this entire county. So thank you again very, very much.
All right. Rocking and rolling here, buddy. Rocking and rolling.
Good
Gentlemen, item six is the consent agenda. You've also had that for more than 10 days. These are for the public at large. These are non-controversial items that we approve at one time. They're fairly routine. If you do have questions about them, contact our county manager, Lance Metzler, and he'll be glad to explain that at length. And so, do I have a motion to approve or alter the consent agenda?
I'll make a motion to approve the consent agenda.
All right, move to approve.
Second.
And seconded. Further discussion? Hearing none. All in favor indicate by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed by nay. It is passed. We're getting ready for public comment. We only have one person signed up tonight, but Mary, you've got to listen to our county manager explain the rules of the game.
Yes, sir.
All right, Mary, you ready?
Ready.
The public comment period shall be for the purpose of allowing members of the public to present any matter pertaining to county business or items on the Board of Commissioners' agenda. Remarks shall be addressed directly to the Board of Commissioners and not to the staff, the audience, or media. The chairperson shall open the public comment period. Any speaker who wishes to speak shall approach the podium and not speak from his or her seat. Each speaker shall clearly state his or her name and physical address when he or she approaches the podium. Any citizen desiring to present any matter concerning the services, policies, and affairs of Rockingham County shall be allotted 3 minutes, which the county manager will time the speaker and notify the chairman of their limit. The clock will start with 3 minutes. You will hear a beep at 1 minute to alert you to wrap up your comments. Skip that part. Speakers appearing before the Board of Commissioners will not be allowed to campaign for public office, promote private business ventures, or use language of a personal nature which insults or demeans any person for which, when directed at a public official, is not related to his or her official duties. Mr. Chair?
Miss Mary, are you ready?
I'm ready. Thank you so very much. Good afternoon. My name is Mary D. Martin. I live at 702 West Idle Street in the western part of the county, and I am the 2019 Citizen of the Year for the great town of Madison. A month or so ago, I came with one of my Junior Beta Club mentees, and they're at volleyball practice and all that stuff, asking to use this building as a place to collect pet food. The drive ended on February 14th, but has been extended until March 2nd because people still want to donate. But as of February 14th, we delivered to the Rockingham County Animal Shelter 659 pounds of pet food.
Wow.
So everybody in the county has really, really done an awesome job. Some of the people, like I said, they had not gotten in their donations, so they asked if I could just leave the boxes out, so I will. Some of the people here, their wife has donated a $100 check that I'm going to make sure the Junior Beta Club gets credit for. Those of you here said that you would donate pet food, so again, that has been extended to March 2nd. Some of you said you were going to donate checks. I've checked with the animal shelter, and they have not yet been processed. I've checked surveillance cameras, and I have not seen you going to the box to add food to the box. So just letting you know, we do have until March the 2nd to get all those items taken care of. The minister said that anything you ask tonight in the name of Jesus is going to happen. So I'm expecting checks, I'm expecting dog food, and anything else that you choose to donate. I talked with the fire marshal earlier in the week because I gave you a couple of weeks ago the community health fair. They're on the community health fair, but I talked with him. He said, well, we don't have the training plan because we were going to do a fire extinguisher training. And I was very glad to hear tonight that they had gotten that because he didn't know if it would be back in time to do the training, and now that is. So those young people that we had scheduled for that will be able to get that training, and some elderly and everybody else will get that too. But again, in the name of Jesus, this is Mary D. Martin, 702 West Idle Street, the western part of the county, and your 2019 Citizen of the Year.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Pryor.
Thank you.
I think I'm going to ask the county manager to review our comments in the future. We might need to adjust our process. We certainly appreciate that. Ronnie Tate, Director of Engineering. That's a lot of dog food, Mary. Congratulations.
Yes, sir. Y'all did a wonderful job. Good evening again, gentlemen. I've got before you tonight asking for board approval to designate March 30th through April 4th, 2020 as free week at the Rockingham County landfill. You have a flyer that was in your packet that it's basically the same we've used for several years to talk about what we do and what we do not accept. We had a solid waste committee meeting and discussed this with the solid waste partners, the towns, and they're on board with that week and approved that week. And so I'm just here to get your approval to declare that free week at the landfill.
Okay. Questions, comments from the board?
I got a question. Ronnie, can you advise the board the status of the cell closure and how this free week might affect that cell closure?
Well, I think you're all aware that we're getting to the top of the hill out there, so to speak, and we've closed part of the cell around the base part, but we're operating on the top part of, for lack of a better term, top part of the mountain, and it is extremely tight up there. Limited space for trash disposal and limited space to stage vehicles as they come in and out. And so we are also, though, the good news is cell 4 is completed. We're waiting DEQ approval to get the permit to operate that cell. And in thinking about trying to do this during that week, our goal is if we do have the permit to operate, we have to put what's called a fluff layer of trash in. First 4 to 6 feet has to be basically household trash. We don't want bulk items or things like that. We're trying to keep from puncturing the liner. And so we'll direct those trucks that have that type of waste on it to the new cell. Anything that's a bulk item or we suspect is a bulk item will get directed to the top of the hill. Now, this is all under the assumption that we're going to get that permit to operate. And it, right now, it's in the hands of DEQ. We expect it, but it's in their hands.
So I wanted to bring that up because if we don't get that permit to open that sale and we have this free week, we might be in a very tight bind. Am I right?
It's going to be congested and time-consuming for the commercial haulers. We just don't have a lot of room up there, and we would have to empty our gate boxes, which are at the convenience site. We have to bring those up there as well. So when you add all of that traffic together in a little space, it's going to be challenging.
Is it doable? Are you asking us to do something we can't do?
No, I'm just asking for, we have a plan in place. We think it'll work. And asking for board approval to designate that week as free week.
Questions, comments?
I'll make a motion for approval of the free week.
Second.
Moved and second. Further discussion?
I just wanted y'all to have the information that was shared at the Waste Committee meeting. Mm-hmm. It's kind of concerning.
Thank you. It's a valid concern. Hearing no further, all in favor indicate by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Those opposed by nay.
Thank you, gentlemen.
You have it there. Mr. Bachelor, new business. Commissioner comments, starting with Commissioner Travis.
No comment.
Commissioner Hall.
Well, I appreciate everyone being here tonight. We have a lengthy meeting at 4 today for water and sewer planning, and we felt like that was very productive. We had a lot of participation from developers and builders in the county. So we appreciate that. But also tonight, I'd like to thank Sheriff Sam Page and his staff for being here. Tony Reese on our elections board, and Paul Kasinowitz, who is the chair of our planning board for Rockingham County. So we appreciate you guys in attendance tonight as well. Thank you.
Commissioner Purtle.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I just want to share something that happened over the weekend, well, Friday night. Friday I had the opportunity to go to the Rockingham County Moorhead basketball game. And it was a great game. And I left a little bit early, and I wished I hadn't. because, and I hope maybe most of y'all have seen what I'm getting ready to talk about. Moyad had a one of their gentlemen that was on the team, part of the team, was a gentleman by the name of Thomas Stowe. Well, Thomas hadn't played all year. He was the manager of the basketball team, but a big, huge supporter. And they surprised Thomas and let him dress out for the game. And a bunch of the kids, I think, knew that it was coming, and they had signs made out to support Thomas. And the sportsmanship demonstrated between those two high schools and their coaches. Thomas got in the game, and Thomas scored a basket. And the fans went crazy. And it's just what's right with our schools and our community. I know, Mr. Metzler, I think you were there and seen that, the electricity in that gym. My daughter come home, and she was bouncing off the walls telling me about it and wanted me to look on where it had been posted on social media. So it was just, I think, a great evening in Rockingham County. A great time was had by all of it, Rockingham County High School. And my hat goes off, like I said, to those kids that participated in the game, to those kids that was there supporting the game on both sides, to the officials. If you look at the video, check one of the officials there clapping, too, when he scored. You can't help but it was good. It was right with high school and with the kids in our community. So with that, Mr. Chairman, I say congratulations to Thomas Stowe, and that's all I have. Thank you.
Thank you, Commissioner Purtle. Commissioner Berger.
Now, we did have a pretty lengthy meeting a little bit earlier on the water and sewer line, and certainly appreciate the folks that came out for that meeting and the input that they provided to us. Don't have anything else.
Thank you, Commissioner Berger. I'd like to remind, thank everybody for being here. We had a larger crowd earlier. I'd like to remind everyone here about our drive within this county to eliminate litter. And this 3-week free dumping is part of the program, but still we've got to stop people from tossing it out to begin with. So anything you can do to help would be appreciated. A couple of announcements. The North Carolina Commissioner of Agriculture, Steve Troxler, wanted me to advise the public that they now have a branch office of the Department of Agriculture at the research station over near Chinkapin. So, Steve is there 2 or 3 days a week. And if you have business to do with the Department of Agriculture or you want to talk to the commissioner, I can tell you that Steve makes himself available on a regular basis, and it's going to be even more convenient. Also, the Lieutenant Governor of North Carolina, Mr. Dan Forrest, the Honorable Dan Forrest, will be in Rockingham County at 11 o'clock on the 29th of this month. You know, I didn't realize that this was a leap year until I saw this date. On the 29th at 11 o'clock in Reidsville at the Republican Center. The headquarters there. So if you get over near the Sanitary Cafe at that time, you'll have the opportunity to see and ask questions, is what I understand of Lieutenant Governor Forrest. Gentlemen, do we have other business to conduct? I would welcome an if.
Second.
Moved and seconded to adjourn. Further discussion. Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed by nay. Thank you all for being here again.